lines as we can get. So that doesn't mean here. It doesn't mean here. It doesn't mean here. Okay, this is a lot with the less flexy hamstrings. They're going to come up here, that person, right? The flexier person's going to sink and drop their shoulders. So we want to find a true downward dog, upside down feet. When we get up here, we need to make sure that the rotation in the shoulders, this is all shoulder, even though I'm moving my arms and my elbows, I'm doing it through the shoulders, okay? So understand the complexity of that. We say move the arm, it's really the shoulder. It's the humerus bone in the shoulder socket. So we need to rotate these pits of the elbows forward in order to separate the shoulder blades. So I'll come over here and do the same thing. So pits of the elbows forward. Opens up. You see how the shoulder blades are pulling apart? I call it hugging around to the sides, right? Shoulder blades hugging to the sides. Does that make sense to everybody? Okay, so as soon as that happens, I roll naturally into the outside edge of my hand, right? Well, the opposite has to happen. So we roll pits of the elbows forward, and then we dig in with the index and thumb knuckle pads. So the energy of the arm is external. Energy of the hand, internal. Okay?
This is also a very complex joint. And we can do it. It just takes practice. Okay? All right, so let's practice downward dog first. Unless you have questions.